You scared me. Who are you? What are you doing here? It's not safe. What? You crashed your car? Are you all right? There's an old hotel nearby. I sort of work there. Anyway, there's a phone in the lobby. You could use it and call for help, I think. Just please make the call and leave, okay? Don't check into a room or anything like that. Look, I know I probably sound a little crazy, but you've got to trust me on this. Wait, I forgot to tell you something. The forest can be a real maze sometimes. Can you remember these directions? On the first split, turn right, then right again, then left and right on the last one. Got it? I'd come with you, but I need to check on the power lines.
Thank you. Come in. A stranger. How unexpected. Nonetheless, welcome to our fine hotel. And what brings you here on such a dark and stormy night? We don't see many guests. Not since the town was flooded. Ah, you crashed your car, I see. Did you happen to notice any downed power poles? Ha! I knew it. Such bad luck. Such bad luck indeed. As a fellow human being, I am duty-bound to help you. However, we're experiencing something of an emergency here as well. Since the electrical power was cut off by nothing other than your crashing car, the phone is dead silent, the lights extinguished. However, my assistant is trying to fix an old generator in the basement, which may alleviate the situation. You could probably check with her and see if it couldn't be done faster. You see, without power, I am unable to provide substantial help, much as I would dearly like to. The staircase leads to our fine rooms. However, I'm afraid I cannot allow you to access them. I'm afraid the rooms are all occupied already. And think about the lack of light. In the darkness, it's easy to slip and break your neck.
Supposed to make the call and leave. The phone isn't working?
Yes. We've got an old switchboard, so you can't make calls if there's no power.
This just isn't your lucky day, is it?
Fortunately, we have a generator. But I can't get it to work. I think it's broken, and, well, you'd better take a look at it. If you help me to get it going, the phone will work too. And then you, could get some help.
Thank you. Thank you.
never figured it out by myself. The phone in the lobby should be working now, so please go and call for help. Will you excuse me now? I need to check if anything else needs my attention.
My, it seems we have returned to the modern age. Undoubtedly, you're doing many things. I think you'll find the phone is working now. Please, feel free to use it if you think it would help. Nobody's coming for you. How terribly unfortunate. You look rather pale. Indeed, as if you'd seen a ghost. Perhaps you need to lie down and rest. Fortunately, I believe we may have one free room after all. It was my assistant's room, but she can make other arrangements. You'll find it upstairs, room 106. And please, do not be startled by our more excitable guests. Notably, the elderly lady who moved in just before the dam collapsed. She may be a little eccentric. However, we must learn to live together. Particularly if we may find ourselves staying here for a while. Don't you think?
Hello there, darling. You must be the pretty new face everyone's talking about. I heard of your unfortunate luck. Just horrible. You're so pale. You should go to bed and rest. But say, maybe you'd like to visit lonely old me in my room when you're rested? We could have a tea and chat for a while. I could tell you a story or two about our beautiful city. Of course, I know it's in ruins now. I'm not crazy, honey. Oh, but I was an important person there once, when it was a prosperous community, and I knew all its secrets, even the nasty little ones.
Thank you.
it's you. I am so glad you came. Did you get my letter? Listen, we don't have much time. We have to get out of here. This place, those people, they... I just can't explain it. I mean, you see it too, right? Don't you? I tell you, I'm not crazy. I can prove it. Something is very wrong. Ever since that dam collapsed, I tried to get away from here, but... Did you hear that? Someone's coming. I need to go. Meet me on the road to the town ruins. Ask the old lady. She knows how to get there. Just promise me. Promise you won't trust them.
Still wandering around, are we? Admiring the view. Of course, it's quite breathtaking. You haven't by any chance seen my assistant. She has a disturbing tendency to occupy our busy guests. I'm deeply sorry if she's been bothering you. I'll make sure that it doesn't happen again. And don't pay too much attention to what she's saying. Her personal life was devastated recently. And I'm not talking about the flood. So it's quite understandable that she becomes easily... confused.
Come on in, darling. I'm waiting. Ah, welcome. Do come in. Oh, I knew you'd come, darling. I know how people work. Let me guess, you'd like to know more about the hotel and town. Honey, who wouldn't? It is such an enticing place. What's more, no one knows it better. I was the wife of the town's mayor, you know, before he passed away, that is, poor soul. Come, sit. Let's have a cup of tea and chat for a while. What am I thinking? I don't have the full set. Honey, would you mind dropping by the kitchen for a teapot? And there should be a teacup in this mess somewhere. I haven't had guests in so long. I get so, so very lonely.
Now, just that teacup, I'm sure it's here somewhere. Oh, thank you so much, darling. I'm just so forgetful these days. Come, let's have a tea party, just like the old days. You know, I used to have guests every Saturday. No, not here, dear. In our downtown residence. I miss it so much. Everyone important was invited. They'd all admire our house. And me. Oh, yes. I used to be a real beauty. Just look at those photographs. Men would do anything for me. Ah, but that's all in the past. The past, the present, the future. Somehow, they all melt together, just like the sugar in our tea. Oh my, I just remembered something. I used to be rather good at reading fortunes. Oh, and I'd love to read yours, sweetheart. What do you say? I, for one, would have done things differently if I had known the consequences. Let's begin. It's really quite simple. Just focus on the symbols on the cards. Now, open your mind and look deep into your cup. If you see something, quickly pick the card that looks the most like it. That's interesting. Yes, yes. Oh, do you see anything else? What could that mean? Oh, really? Focus, darling, focus. I see. That's interesting. What could that mean? Oh, really? Focus more. I see. That's interesting. Yes. Oh, do you see anything else? What could that mean? Oh, really? I see. That's interesting. Yes, I'm interested. Yes. What could that mean? Oh, really? I see. Good. Now, let's see what the future holds for you. Oh, now that is most interesting. I see a chain, a door, a maze with no exit. You are trapped in the past, your future, taken away from you, locked away. I see a trap. It's about to close, and you don't have much time left. I see... Oh my, honey, I think you'd better get used to our lovely hotel. Because it looks like you're going to be here for a while. My dear, wait. There's something you should know before you leave. There's an old road in the forest leading to a crossroad. From there, you can reach the ruins of the town and also the highway. I'll tell you how to get there. It's so easy to lose your way. Go back to the old shack in the forest and take the path to the left. On the first split, go left and then go right. Then go left 2 times and finally turn right. If you forget these directions, you know where to find me.
Oh, thank you for coming. I was afraid you wouldn't show up. Listen, I'm sorry for what I said before. I realize how it all sounds, but it's true. We're trapped here, and something unnatural is going on. Look, I know you're not going to believe me without proof, so I'll give you some. See that road left from here? It leads through the forest to the highway. It's the only exit from here, the only escape route, or at least it should be. The road just makes you... No, you'll just have to go and see for yourself.
Thank you.
here you are. I've been looking everywhere for you. It's the road, isn't it? You see now? Something is keeping us here. Or someone. The owner and the old lady. There's something disturbing about them. The way they look at you and the way they talk. It all started during the flood. Everyone was told to evacuate, but they decided to stay. I mean, I had to stay too, but that's different. I had my own reasons. Sometimes I wish I'd just left. I have this feeling they're hiding something, some dark secret. We just need to find out what it is, and I think I know where to start looking. Let's meet on the road to the town again. It's time to search those ruins. I'll tell you more once we get there.
Again, darling. Come to admire the view. It wasn't always a lake, you know. Once it was a beautiful town, but then the dam collapsed. I often come here myself, especially on a night like this. See how clear the water is? You can still see the rooftops. Can you see the tower over there? That was our church. Our house is just a few steps away. I mean, it was. We had the biggest, most beautiful residence in the whole town. Every woman was jealous of what I had, and I liked it that way. Oh, good times. Oh my, look at the time. I'm afraid you have to excuse me. There are other landmarks that I would like to visit as well. See you soon, dear.
Thanks for getting here so quickly. Look, normally I wouldn't ask anyone to search the ruins. Part of the town is flooded and they say the place is haunted. But a few months ago, this strange man came to town. He was wandering around for days. You know, like he was searching for something. I was too afraid to talk to him back then. But now I realize we could use any help at all. After all, he could know something, right? I haven't seen him recently, but I hope he's still around. We should look for him and for any other clues to what's going on.
combination to the lock is 1, 4, 8, 4, 2.
Thank you.
I'm down in the basement. I found something strange. You've got to see this. Anything like this before? It certainly wasn't here earlier. Looks like something constructed recently. I mean, it looks abandoned, but not as old as the ruins. I wonder what the diving suit's for. It looks completely functional. You think someone wanted to search the underwater part of the city? But this doesn't make any sense. There can't be anything of major value down there. Whatever people left should all be rusty junk by now. No. This is something different. It looks like the work of a madman. Someone who is very skilled and probably obsessed. Do you think there's a way to make all this machinery work? I really don't know what to make of it.
I came to these cursed ruins. I haven't yet pinpointed the location of the stolen money with full certainty, but I've got at least a few leads worth investigating. If I would have to guess, the money is hidden somewhere in the sunken part of the town. I started assembling machinery that will let me search this area. So far, it's all going well. However, I can't shake off the feeling that I'm being observed. Weird. This place was supposed to be deserted for years.
Thank you.
Well, well, who do we have here, if it isn't our new guest? You just won't stay in your cozy hotel room, will you? I take it you decided to go sightseeing in the town? Rather thought-provoking, don't you think? One moment a lively community, full of busy little people and their all-important matters. The next, a sinister, dead, quiet shadow of the long-gone past. Oh yes, there's certainly a lot to see around here. Although, I'd watch my step if I were you. This place is full of secrets, and some secrets are much better when left alone.
Find anything besides that weird diving suit? What? There's a dead body in the same building? This must be the man I told you about. No, the body can't be that old. I saw the man alive just a few months back. I must have lost track of time. Could it really be so long ago? What? You also met the hotel owner here? What did he say? He threatened you? Really? I guess I shouldn't be surprised. After all, there are those rumors about him. Listen, they say that he... Wait, you think he might still be around? We should talk somewhere else. It's not safe. Let's meet in the hotel basement. I'll tell you what I know.
Thank you.
Talk safely now. I know very little about the hotel owner. He's one big mystery. One day he just showed up in the town and started spending lots of money. Some even said he was a runaway gangster. But hear this, he wasn't the first to run the hotel. The previous owner, well, let's just say he disappeared, without any trace. People speculated a lot. Some even said horrible, gruesome things. I'm sure the old lady knows more, but I don't trust her. Do you know that every night she sneaks out to the cemetery? If you use this old elevator to go down to the water, you could take the boat there. Listen, I suspect what's going on, but it's just too crazy to tell now. We need more evidence before I start throwing wild theories straight out of the Twilight Zone.
Thank you.
Oh, it's you, darling. I wasn't expecting to meet anyone here. So, you'd like to hear the story of an old lady weeping in the rain over the grave in which she buried her love? How about I tell you something else? A true love story with a bitter end, perhaps. There was this young girl in our town, a hopeless romantic, naive little goose. The man who stole her heart promised to marry her in a secret wedding. It all happened the same day the dam collapsed. And guess what? He never showed up. And the poor girl drowned in the church, waiting for him. That's how life usually goes. First, you want something very bad. And then, when you finally have it, the murky waves come and everything you care about is suddenly gone. So, so sad. Darling, you shouldn't ask so many questions. We had a visitor some time ago who also was sniffing around. I think he was constructing something in the ruins. But I've also seen him here, wandering around the cemetery. He used to sneak things into the old lodge on the hill. Anyway, I haven't seen him recently, but I'm pretty sure he didn't just leave. So if I were you, dear, I'd watch my back.
Thank you.
don't know what's going on anymore. It's either he didn't die in the flood or something else. I feel he's watching me. When I sleep, when I search the town, when I analyze clues, all the time. He's waiting for the right moment to strike. I'm sure of it. But no, oh no, I won't give up that easily. If I don't get this money, then no one will. No one! I disassembled my machine and hid the parts so that no one of a mind lesser than mine would find them. You hear me? No one will ever find them. Not even you!
Thank you.
worried. Of course, you were searching the cemetery for clues. Well, did you see the old lady there? Did you find anything? A device hidden inside a coffin? That's really strange. So those things are somehow linked to the diving suit we found in the city? I know you could try to activate it now, but is that really necessary? What if something really bad happens? What if the lady and the hotel owner are these evil ghosts, and you just succeed in driving them crazy? Don't laugh at me. If you've got a better explanation, let's hear it. I'm starting to have second thoughts about helping you. At least for now, we're still alive. But who knows what could happen if you dive in the sunken parts of the town. I just hope you know what you're doing.
Already back from the town, I see. Well, did you find whatever you've been looking for? As I said, some secrets are best left buried. And believe me, this town has plenty. On the surface, it was a vibrant and prosperous community. But take away the facade of fake smiles, and it's all rotten to the bone. Even the creme de la creme, like the town's mayor. A powerful, intelligent, and wealthy man. But so naive. He marries a beautiful young woman and dies in unknown circumstances. His wife inherits everything. Suspicious, isn't it? But life has to go on. Some will say he was murdered, poisoned. But most will live their own lives and keep up appearances. Because, my friend, sometimes it's better to know very little than to know the whole ugly truth.
Thank you. Thank you.
It couldn't be anyone else but you again. I told you not to stick your nose into our secrets. I tried to be a nice host, but no, you had to cross the line. You wanted to get away so badly, and now... now you will stay here forever. What? You say that I'm dead? That I am a ghost? That's very amusing. After all, it's you who's just been in a car crash. Maybe I did break my precious neck falling down there after all. Now, I shall just have to get rid of you. Just like I got rid of the previous owner. And the man who was searching for my stolen money. You can't do anything to stop me. There's nothing to connect me to my former life. You have no proof. Wait, what's that? No, no, it can't be. Trying to hide the money I stole. I had the chance to start a normal life, but I wasted it. Old habits die hard. The deed you hold is perfect proof of that. I know I can't correct the many mistakes that I've made, but at least now I can move on. Thank you, stranger, for helping me find my closure. But remember, you haven't solved all the mysteries just yet.
Thank you.
Why did you do it, darling? Why did you have to open old wounds? We could have been such dear friends. We could have had tea parties every Saturday. But now, you've ruined it all. What? You think I'm a ghost? Oh, my dear, you should know better. I am the mayor's wife. Everyone knows who I am. I don't like your tone, darling. Stop saying those lies. You're delusional. There's no way I killed my husband. You don't have any proof.
What is this, dear? It looks so familiar. Oh, it was so long ago. Help me remember.
Everything is now so clear. I committed some sinful things back then. I can't believe I poisoned my husband. He loved me so much. Oh, but it wasn't enough for me. I couldn't stand living in his shadow. I was always just the mayor's wife. Very soon after he drank the poison, I knew that I'd made a horrible mistake. But it was too late. The last thing I remember is crying out loud over his grave. And then the waves came. Thank you, dear heart, for helping me remember. I hope you'll find your way. I send you a very
will be.
doing here?
Is it all over? Am I really dead? I was lying to myself for so many years. But now, thanks to you, I know the truth. Thank you for setting me free.